he is giving an expression to that kind of a paschaptapam, we call it, so he is expressing it. He says, nāyam vedasvam ātmānam yachyatyāyan yachyatyāham dhiyāhatam tam duratyaya mahātmyam bhagavanta mitosmyaham. Nāyam vedasvam ātmānam yachyatyā aham dhiyāhatam. So, Parameshvara has given you a great shakti, vijnana shakti he has given to pursue jnana yoga. Kriya shakti he has given to you to pursue karma yoga. But what you have done, you have destroyed those shaktis. Hatam. So, dekha, hatam mane word in English, in Hindi they say satyanash kar diya. So that is how they present that word hatam. So the greatest faculties that Bhagavan has endowed us with, we have destroyed them, we have spoiled them. By what? Aham dhiya. Because of the ahankara. So this abhimana tyagam, that is being mentioned again. You see, I remember a story. Once Satyabhama and Garuda is the chariot for Bhagavan. And Chakram is also considered as a devata. Sudarshana devata it is. That is how the Bhakti Shastram presents it. So Chakra means Chakra Devata, Sudarshana Devata it is. Sudarshana Stotram and other things are there. In fact, the Chakram has got the name Sudarshana means Sushtu Darshanam Yasya Saha. It has got wonderful knowledge. That means what? It is a Devata. So this is Chakra. All these three. So the Kansart of Parameshvara and the Vahanam and also his weapon. All the three, they developed an Abhimana. Abhimana means we are great. So Satyabhama feels, oh Lord, Krishna is in my hand, Mera Mukti, Meri Mukti. Like that is he feels. And Sudarshana feels, if Bhagavan has to achieve Dharma Rakshanam by killing these demons and all that, he has to depend upon me. Is it right? Okay, very good. So, and if Garuda feels, Bhagavan, wherever he has to go, he has to call me only. So these three people have got lot of abhimana. Then Bhagavan wanted to teach them a lesson. So he called Garuda and asked him, Hanuman is there in some place, his address is known to Ishvara. So he said to Garuda, Lord Krishna says to Garuda, so you go and call Hanuman, I have a word to talk with him. So I want to talk with him, you call him. So he wanted to teach a lesson to these three people in one shot, not separately. All the three are targeted in one effort. So this Garuda goes to Hanuman. Hanuman is quite an old man, old looking man rather, old looking vanara. So Garuda goes and tells him, so Lord Krishna wants to come on. So he wants to talk with you. Hanuman said, okay, I received the message. No, come on, I have to take you. You sit on my back, piggybacking. So come on, I will take you there. Hanuman told you, what Krishna told you? Did he ask you to bring me on your back? No, he did not tell that, but it is understood. No, he did not tell that, right? No, he did not tell that, but come on, I say, you sit on my back. Hanuman told, don't bother, you go on your way. Garuda told, no, nothing doing. Are you sitting on my back? Or I will physically put you on my back and take. Then Hanuman, chalo bhai, like that, he pushed his hand like this. And the Garuda, he was, by the strength of that hand pushing, he was thrown into the center of the ocean. And he became unconscious and he was in that ocean. He fell in that ocean. Then Hanuman, he put three or four jumps and he came to Dwaraka. So in three or four jumps he came to Dwaraka. And he was about to enter into the prasadam, the antapura of Bhagavan Lord Krishna. So this chakram is the protector. It is the guard. It is at the gate of the Dwaraka. So the chakra devata, Sudarshana devata told, who are you? I am Hanuman. Bhagavan has sent a message to me. He wants to talk with me. Therefore, please let me go in. Chakra says, no, I did not receive any such message. So Hanuman told, you please confirm inside. No, I am not going to confirm either. So you please get out. Who are you? You are looking like a monkey, useless monkey, please get out. Then Hanuman, he held that chakram in his hand and put in his mouth. So it was just like in one corner of his mouth. He entered inside. Sri Krishna was sitting on the Simhasanam and Satyabhama was sitting beside him. So Hanuman came. So Hanuman, how are you? He prostrated before Bhagavan. Hey Bhagavan, I have seen you long, long back when you were Rama, Ramavataram. I remember all those wonderful days when I was your messenger and all that. So he was so happy and so much ananda is expressed in the form of tears passing through his eyes like a stream. So he touches the feet of Bhagavan. He performs an abhisheka to the feet of the Bhagavan with those tears. So he is in extreme ananda. And he praises the glory of the Bhagavan. Then Satyabhama is sitting beside her, beside him. She was wondering, why this man doesn't look at me at all? So he appears to be a great bhakta, no doubt, because she only heard about Hanuman. She did not see him any time. So she did not know the other part of it, so the greatness of Hanuman. So then Lord Krishna, he noticed the discomfiture of Satyabhama. And he asked Hanuman, "Hey Hanuman, you are doing pranam to me, all right. Why don't you do pranam to her also?" Then Hanuman says, "I only do pranam to our Sita Amma, nobody else." And by the way, Bhagavan, who is this lady who is sitting beside you? Like that he says. So Satyabhama was so ashamed. She goes inside, she cannot sit anymore. Then Bhagavan says, "What is there in your, that a cheek something is appearing? Oh Bhagavan, this is Sudarshana Chakram of yours." So he takes it out and gives, "Please keep it." In the meanwhile, this Garuda comes. He's shattered and his wings are also disturbed a bit. With some difficulty he came, like an old man walking with a stick, some difficulty he came. Then Bhagavan asked Garuda, "Why you are looking like that as if you are beaten by people? What happened to you?" "So, sir, that only happened. This Hanuman, he has pushed me aside and so this happened." So in one shot, he has taught a lesson to all the people. So the idea is Abhimanam should not be there. Abhimanatyagam is the key, is the secret of Jnana or Karma Yoga or Bhakti. Abhimanatyaga. In fact, one Mahatma told, if you recognize Abhimana anywhere, you can immediately conclude that he is not a Jnani. Because Jnanam and Abhimanam, they can never coexist. Because they are opposite to each other. Where Jnanam is there, Abhimana cannot be there, vice versa. So that Abhimana, he is just resolving Aham Dhiya Hatam. This Abhimana or Ahankara, it kills this great virtue, that a great faculty that is given to the human being, it is destroyed by this Abhimana. So what is the result? Ayam Svam Atmanam Naveda. He doesn't know his own Swarupa. What can be a more pitiable situation than that? Therefore, he Prameshwara, all this is because of your Mahima only. Kriya Shakti, Vijnana Shakti is your Mahima. But then the Ajnanam which covers them, under the Maya Shakti, that is also your Mahima only. So, ta mameva ye prapadjante maya metam tarantite, that is what Bhagavan says in Gita. So this Maya, you cannot overcome this Maya or this avidya on your strength. You have to go and do Sharanagati at the feet of Bhagavan. On that strength, by the strength of Ishvara Krupa alone, you will be able to cross this obstacle called Maya. Therefore he says, tam duratyaya mahatmyam. So the Mahima of Ishvara, which is mahatmyam, is Mahima, which is Maya, duratyaya. So it cannot be crossed by oneself on his own strength. Only Ishvara Krupa can help you to cross it. So that kind of Mahima you have, hey Bhagavan. Aham itaha asmi. Itaha means gataha. So in gatau, that is the dhatu. So eti itahayanti also you must have heard, itaha is gataha. So I am prostrating before you and I am doing sharanagati. So he has no desire, he did not express any particular desire to save himself or not. He did not express any of that. He said, I want jnanam, I want moksha parama purushartha, and I am not in a hurry too. So kalena, it will come on its own. So now the alligator is dragging it further and further, so it's only a matter of minutes before the Gajendra dies and he is ready for it. And his heart is on Ishvara. What a death it is. If, even if it happens, you can there is no sorrow in it. Thus, that is the type of death. So in Gita Bhagavan says, Omiti Vyaharan Mamanusmaran Yah Prayati. It starts like that. Omiti Vyaharan Mamanusmaran Yah Prayati Tyajan Deham Sa Shanti Mithigacchati. Something like that in the sixth dhyaya. Sayati Paramamagitam. What is the beginning? Omityekaksharam Brahma Dhyayan Mamanusmaran Vyaharan Mamanusmaran. So you say Om, and you are at the same time contemplating the Mahima of Ishvara, the Parameshvara, and in the meanwhile death overtakes. What can be a better thing than that? That is a wonderful thing. One cannot ask for more than that. In fact, I know a great Mahatma. He was traveling in the bus, an RTC bus in Andhra Pradesh. He is a great Mahatma. He is traveling RTC bus. So in the midnight, the RTC bus met with an accident. So the bus has gone and head-on collision with a tree. The driver, he was effect of alcohol or maybe sleeping, head-on collision with the tree. And this Mahatma was sitting in the front row. And he received the maximum blow. And his entire body was soaked with blood and big injuries he got. Nobody knows, it's all darkness. Some light was there. In the meanwhile, he was caught up in the mangled seats. So he was still alive. He requested, please help me to come out of the bus. He was one of the serious injured persons. Other people were less injured. So somehow the less injured and the non-injured people, they somehow managed to take him out from those seats and helped him to come out of the bus. So immediately he sat under the tree. There is a tree. He sat under the tree and he sat in Padmasana. So Samakaya Shirogrivaha, he is a great Mahatma, a yogi. So Samakaya Shirogrivaha, he sat erect and started Om and he died. What a death it is. I was amazed to see when the conductor and the bus driver is injured. When they described it, when other people described it, we were all stunned by the greatness of that Mahatma. So that is the type of death, a wonderful death. So Gajendra is in that situation. So it doesn't matter whether he dies also, it really doesn't matter. But then Bhagavan has got some other ideas. Sri Shuka Uvacha Tam Tadvadattam Upalabhya Jagan Nivasaha Stotran Nishamya Divijaisaha Saunstuvadhihi Sotsandomayena Garudena Samushyamanaha Chakrayudhobhyagamadashu yato Gajendraha. So this stotram of Parameshwara, of this Gajendra, was heard by Parameshwara. He heard it and he understood that the Gajendra is in a very serious distress and any more delay would put an end to his life. And when this stotram is coming and he was hearing this stotram, devatas like Brihaspati, Brahmaji, etc., they all understood that something great is going to happen. They have understood because the place is frequented by these apsarasas and devatastris. So they suddenly came there and they saw this whole scene. Immediately they ran back and reported to the Indra, etc. So they all became alert. So something is going to happen. They were also started, when Gajendra is doing this stotram, they also joined him in this stotram. So then Parameshwara, he did not wait anymore. He arrived in the scene by Garuda. He arrived. So in Potana described it in a beautiful way. So one more Telugu Padyam. Siri Kinjappadu Shankachakra Yogamun Jedo Ye Sandhimpadu. So this is Potana's own idea. So when a person goes into the street and the head of the family, so he goes out. He tells the lady of the house, hello, I am going out. Like that he tells. It is a custom and he is supposed to do it also. So, but now he is in such a big hurry that he did not tell Lakshmi Devi. Siri King Jappadu, Shankha Chakra Yogamun Jedo Yi Sandhimpadu. Generally while you are going out, you put the shirt on and just the crossing and see in the mirror and then you go out. So, this Parameshwara, he did none of those things. So when he goes out, he is supposed to carry the Shankha Chakra, Gada, etc. in his hands. He doesn't do all that. Shankha Chakra Yogamun Jedo Yi Sandhimpadu. A parichara tulun jiradu. So he will call a servant to keep his chapels or boots, etc. ready. So he did not do any of those things. Abhragapatim bannimpadu. At least the person takes the keys of the car and opens the garage and enters into the car. He doesn't do that also. So his charioteer, namely the Garuda, he did not even give a message to the Garuda. And he started. This is Telugu. Here Garuda is there, he came by Garuda. In Telugu Potanna, he kept even Garuda aside. So Bhagavan is in such a big hurry, he did not even bother to take the help of Garuda. Suppose you are expecting a friend in the railway station. So you start running to receive the friend. Or to save your devotee, you are started running. Instead of running, it is better you take your car. So similarly for Bhagavan, it will be better if he takes the help of the Garuda. But then he doesn't have his mind, he doesn't have time for that also. So he ignores the Garuda. Garuda comes behind. He was coming from behind. Bhagavan is coming. He was running and coming to save the Gajendra. So Abhragapatim Bannimpadu, Akarnikantara Dhammillamu Jakkanottadu. So the hair was a very disheveled hair. Naturally, Jakkanottadu means he is supposed to adjust it a bit in a beautiful way with a comb and all that. He did not do that. And one more thing, that hurry of Ishvara to save his devotee is presented in a very emotional way. How Dhammillamu Jakkanottadu Vivada Prothita Shri Kuchopari Chelanchelamaina Vedadu. So he was playing some Rami or something with Lakshmi Devi. Some cards he was playing. So while playing, he put a card and she objected to that. You have not played correctly. A fair game you did not play. So she objected. So he is trying to make a mischief in the game. She objected. No, that is mischievous play. That was the point at which he started to save the Gajendra. So then when she said, you are playing mischief, he caught hold of her sari, that end of the sari. He caught hold of that sari and told her, no Lakshmi, I did not make mischief. Like that he caught hold. And then now he is running to save Gajendra. He should leave it. He should not carry it and proceed. He should leave it. So, vivada prothita. Vivada means a small argument. And that prothita means he caught hold of her, end of her sari like this. Shri Kuchopari Chalanchalamo, this upper cloth, he should leave it. If anybody sees how bad it will be, but he doesn't have the mind to even leave it. So along with it he is running. And when he is running, how Lakshmi can remain back when the sari is being dragged? So she has to protect herself, she has to run behind. When Lakshmi is running, Garuda is running. And Chakram and Shankha, they are running from behind. This is how Potana presents it. So, Shikuchopari Chalanchalamaina Vidadu. What is this hurry? Where from this great hurry? Gajapranavanotsahiyai. The entire hurry is to save the life of that Gajendra. So, this is how Potana describes it. So, Bhakti, Bhakti is presented in a very sweet way. Bhakti is always sweet. It is having a laddu in the meals. The Bhakti is like that. So anyway, the Bhagavan has arrived. Here you see how Vyasa Maharshi presented Chakra Yudhobhyagamadashu Yato Gajendraha. So Bhagavan has arrived in the last, generally Bhagavan arrives only in the last minute it appears. So he tests our patience and he arrives in the last minute. Sontasarasurubalena Gruhita Aptaha Drushtva Garutmati Harinkha Upatta Chakram. The first thing he did is, he made himself visible to this Garutma, this Gajendra. Yajendra is not expecting his life to be saved. That desire is, that abhimana is already gone. So Gajendra is just waiting for the death. He was being dragged and dragged and dragged by the leg. So except eyes and a little part of the nose are above water, and the rest of it is all going under the water. So he is just praying to Ishvara. He cannot even utter any sounds. So just praying Ishvara in that last minutes of the life. So when he is just like that praying, then he saw Ishvara there. Vishnu was appearing before him. This is something which he did not expect. Urubalena drihita artaha. He was being dragged by a very powerful alligator and he is about to die. Artaha means he is a dying person. He is a dying elephant. But suddenly he saw this Ishvara. So Ishvara darshanam before death. That is also a great thing. So the Parameshwara he saw. And Parameshwara is now, he is taking his chakram out and keeping it ready to kill this alligator. In that posture he saw the Parameshwara. But then he did the most appropriate thing. Utkshitya sambhujakaram giramaha kruchkat narayana akhila guru bhagavan namaste. He took out some last reserves of energy. He tapped. So in the body there are always one last reserve of energy will be there. That is the last, and that is also spent means the fellow will die. So he tapped that energy and somehow gained a very little ground by pulling the alligator one step ahead, and he managed to pick up one small lotus from there. In the very beginning I gave a description of the saras, that lake, lotuses were there. So he managed to pick up one lotus with his tusk and he offered that lotus to Ishvara. And also managed to say one word, only one word he could manage. What is that? Narayana Akhila Guru Bhagavan Namaste. Narayana is a name of the Ishvara. Akhila Guru, Guru is the father. The father is called Guru. So the father of the entire universe. So Akhila Guru Bhagavan Namaste. So he doesn't have any more energy to show more than this. He offered the flower and said this and gave up. So that means more or less he is ready to die. Tam vikshya pidita majaha sahasa avatirya. So there you have your avataram, avatirya. This is the avatar. So very sometime back I described this avatara from the point of view of a devotee. So avatara means avatarati. Ava niche tarati. Hindi mein one Mahatma said kudna. So that is the tarati. Is it okay? Kudna is a correct word? No? Kudna means jumping into. That is what Bhagavan says. That is avatara. So avatirya. Now Bhagavan, he observed this last minutes of dying moments of that Gajendra, and so he entered into the, he jumped into the lake. That is avatara, avatirya. Because why he jumped? If he directs the Gajendra to go to that spot, Gajendra has to approach it in a planned way, like an aeroplane and all that. So Gajendra may delay. Therefore the best way is to jump out. So he left them, sorry, not Gajendra, Garuda. So Garuda, I'm sorry, so Garuda can approach the place. So he can direct the Garuda to reach that point. But then it may take some delay, it may make some delay. So he decided, forget about the Garuda. He jumped from, so he ejected himself from that Garuda. And he jumped into the Saras. So keeping this in mind only the other day, I have tried to explain the word avatara, so that exactly he jumped into this lake. And sagrahamasu sarasaha krupayojjahara. So how, why he jumped? Out of an intense love, affection, grace, karuna. So because of, and a feeling of compassion, he jumped into that saras. Grahat vipatita mukhad arina gajendram. Arina means chakrena. Sampashyatam hari mamuchat hari mamumucha dusriyanam. This is Bhagavatam. Sanskrit is quite tough. Usriyanam means devanam. Sampashyatam. While devatas are seeing stunned, they were just seeing like that. And generally దేవతానాం సంపశ్యతాం, స్త్రీయాణం సంపశ్యతాం. సో దట్ షష్ఠి సతి సప్తమి, యు మస్ట్ హావ్ హెర్డ్ సతి సప్తమి. దిస్ ఈజ్ సంథింగ్ లైక్ ఎ షష్ఠి. దేవతాసు పశ్యత్సు సత్సు, దేవేషు పశ్యత్సు సత్సు, వై ది దేవాస్ ఆర్ సీయింగ్ దట్ ఈస్ సతి సప్తమి. బట్ హియర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ సతి సప్తమి, ఇన్ ద సేమ్ మీనింగ్ షష్ఠి. సో దేవానాం అపశ్యత సంపశ్యతాం, వైల్ దేవాస్ ఆర్ జస్ట్ కేర్ఫుల్లీ అబ్జర్వింగ్ వాట్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు హ్యాపన్. సో దిస్ షష్ఠి పాణిని సూత్రం ఈస్ దేర్ ఫర్ ఇట్. షష్ఠి చానాదరే, సో అనాదరే, వైల్ ద పీపుల్ హూ ఆర్ సీయింగ్ వెరీ కేర్ఫుల్లీ, భగవాన్ ఇగ్నోర్డ్ దెమ్ అండ్ సేవ్డ్ హిమ్. దట్ ఇగ్నోర్డ్ మీనింగ్ ఈస్ దేర్ ఇన్ ద షష్ఠి. షష్ఠి చానాదరే, అనాదరే షష్ఠి స్యాత్. సో వెన్ అనాదరా మీన్స్ ఇగ్నోరింగ్, నాట్ కేరింగ్ ఫర్, దట్ మీనింగ్ ఈజ్ ఇంప్లైడ్ షష్ఠి విల్ కమ్. అండ్ వీ హ్యావ్ ఎ సిమిలర్ యూసేజ్ ఇన్ రామాయణం ఆల్సో. సో హనుమాన్ సేస్ శిలాభిస్తు ప్రహరత పాదపైశ్చ సహస్రశః అర్ధయిత్వా పురీం లంకాం అభివాద్య చ మైథిలీం సమృద్ధార్థో గమిష్యామి మిషతాం సర్వరక్షసాం. వైల్ ఈవెన్ ఆల్ ది డెమన్స్ ఆర్ లుకింగ్ ఎట్ మీ without caring for them, that meaning is there in it. Without caring for them, you don't find words there. So mishatam, mishatam means while they are looking at me. So being a shashti, anadara is meant. So without caring for them, I will go, having fulfilled my job. Samuddhartaha gamishyam mishatam sarvarakshasam. That is an example for shashti chanadare. This is another example. Anyway, so harihi parameshwaraha, Brahmaji, Indra, etc., they are there. Suppose now, hello, how are you? Suppose he wants to take VIPs, they are all. Suppose this Hari takes care of the VIPs. In the meanwhile, Gajendra is gone. Like even some tufan or some earthquake comes. So all the local administration is busy in receiving the VIPs and all that. So the ministers, etc., they arrive. So the local administration is busy with receiving them. Therefore, what happens? The activity of help, the helping activity comes to a halt because of this VIP visits. So similarly, Indra, Brahma, etc., VIPs are there. If Bhagavan takes care of the VIPs, then Gajendra's life is in peril. Therefore, he ignored them. And one more thing, Gajendra is a greater bhakta than Indra and Brahma, etc. Because they are the bhaktas, they were also bhaktas, all right. But they have worshipped him for the sake of some position, etc. Whereas Gajendra, he doesn't want even to be saved. He doesn't want even his life. So he wants only moksha and jnanam. And he is ready to wait for it. He is not in a hurry. No agenda. Nothing, only sharanagati. And accept sharanagati, doing sharanagati and leave it in the hands of Ishvara. Nothing more than that. So Bhagavan has got a more commitment towards Gajendra than towards devatas. Therefore, for him, Gajendra is more beloved than devatas, because Gajendra happens to be such a great bhakta. So then immediately sahasa avatirya, Bhagavan was he was filled with the emotion of krupa, that is compassion, and amumuchat, he killed arina vipatita mukhat avgrahat amumuchat. Ari is chakram. So arina vipatita mukhat, he used the chakram and destroyed it, the face of that alligator. He cut the face of the alligator into pieces, and the alligator was killed instantaneously, and Gajendra was relieved from the alligator. And Harihi Amumuchat. And then Bhagavan touches the Gajendra, and all his pain and everything has gone, and he is saved. So this is how he was Gajendra Mokshanam it is. So it is not only Mokshanam. Mokshanam means getting released. So it is release of Gajendra not only from the jaws of death, from the jaws of the alligator, which means the jaws of death, also from the jaws of samsara. Samsara is the real alligator. Alligator is ajnanam, moham is the alligator. So from that moha, from that sammoha, which is the cause of a person's death and samsara, going down in the samsara, from that Bhagavan has saved him. Amumuchat. That word amumuchat is lung, munchati. Lung is amumuchat, very, very interesting usage. Apu pujat, pujayati apu pujat. So that lung prayoga it is. So So he released him. He helped him to get relieved. He was released from the clutches of the alligator.
तदा देवर्षि गंधर्वाः ब्रह्मेशान पुरोगमाः मुचुः कुसुमासारं शंसन्तः कर्म तद्धरेः नेतुर्दुन्दुभयो दिव्याः गंधर्वानमृतुर्जगुः ऋषयश्चारण सिद्धास्तुष्टुवुः पुरुषोत्तमम्. देन दि देवतास ऋषीस एंड गंधर्वास एक्सेट्रा दे ऑल असेंबल्ड देयर. ब्रह्मा हैज कम देयर, ईशाना रुद्र हैज कम एंड इंद्रा एक्सेट्रा दे ऑल्सो केम. They have showered flowers on Parameshwara. Shamsantah karmat dharez. So Hari Parameshwara is bhakta krupakaraha. He protects the devotees. His compassion knows no bounds. So like that they were praising the glory of Ishvara. And the deva dunduhayaha. So the drum beaters of the celestial drum beaters, they were making a big celebration there. Gandharva nanurutur jaguhu. So the celestial singers were singing the glory of Ishvara, while the celestial dancers were dancing. Rishayaha charanas siddhaha. So rishis means the great jnanis, and siddhas means they are also jnanis. By birth a jnani is called siddha. After some very sacred life he becomes a jnani. He is called rishi. So small difference. Siddha means by birth he is a jnani. Kapila Siddha, like that they say. So small difference between the words. So all these jnanis and the mahatmas, they were praising the glory of Ishvara, Purushottamam Tushtuvuhu. So this is the Gajendra Mokshanam. It has got Phalashruti also. It is given after some more abhyayas. One more abhyaya is there, describing the past life of Gajendra and all that. I find it is not very significant. Only this part is significant. So the allegory and everything is in very beautifully described. So whosoever listens to this Gajendra Moksham, he will gain that intense devotion to Parameshwara and his abhimana is destroyed and his devotion will take him in the correct path and he will become a jnani and he will be saved by Ishvara from this clutches of samsara, like even Gajendra is saved. So this is the philosophy. So we have completed. ओम स्वस्ति प्रजाभ्यः परिपालयन्तां न्यायेन मार्गेण महीं महिषा गोब्राह्मणः.